Got Santiago back out here. You know, remember we kind of go between Santiago and Jorge. Some of y'all gave Jorge a hard time on the last pour. He did a good team effort and worked in late, so be a little easy. We'll see if y'all are a little easier on Santiago today. We're ready. It's 4:45 a.m. What do you think?
Ooh. Yay.
See? Look how much happier we look when it's not 9,000 degrees outside.
That's true. We got a nice little summer breeze going.
You know, and we got all the lights set up. James set those up yesterday, which I'm glad I got him to do because where's James?
Not here.
James!
You coming?
Oh, I just told James to stay home. He didn't get up till 4, too late. We're going to do it. And this is interesting today because we can see how well the lights work. So if we need to do some nighttime work out here. Casey's here. He's getting his stuff out.
The first concrete truck is pulling up. About 5:22. So we'll only have 4 trucks today. So this will go pretty fast. McDonald's, man.
Oh, wait, that's the South.
Pat Brown?
Man, what you got in there?
All right, we got Santiago back out here. They done gave him a new truck. Even after DOT stopped him twice and blew a tire, they decided to reward all that with a new truck. Alright. That's not much money I'm spending with CMP. They just buy me a new truck.
So we're pouring for the steps first?
So what it does is, because you see how the extra comes out the bottom, just like when we pour mono pour the pool, pour it the step down first, let it set up some, and when they pour the rest, it'll hold it.
Is this blue smear in the video or just on the lens?
No, it's just on the lens.
Or the viewfinder?
Yeah, it's where it got too hot.
Gotcha. So here's these. A little bit more here.
truck three's pulling in, so this is about where we got to figure it out.
Our club. But yep. We ain't bumped enough to figure that out yet. So.
This thing sounds like it's going to take off.
Huh?
It sounds like it's going to take off. Oh, it's rocking. Rocking and rolling.
Like a fountain of concrete. Look at that. Man, look. Oh. Sorry, we'll straighten that one up before it dries.
Seems a little light today. Like maybe we're not getting 10 yards every time. We got to check.
What do you think? 5 more yards here?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, get that on video. Look, it got all quiet.
About 10 yards? You needed that little bit of mud right there.
Yeah, I needed that little bit. We're talking about, look, man. We're talking about again. Y'all was hard on Jorge for no reason. He was out here working hard for me.
Look.
You know who I think gave him the most crap though? It's Santiago.
What?
Jorge.
I gave him the most crap?
Yeah. I didn't ever.
Because he was talking crazy, man.
Alright, so here's the deal. We have pumped 3 trucks out. We knew before the third truck started pumping that we were gonna, you know, we did 30 plus. So if you're new to concrete, that means that when you call your order in, you're not exactly sure how much you're gonna need. So you say, you know I'm gonna need at least 30 yards, you say 30 plus. And that way they leave the ticket open and there's some other things that go into it. So we did 30 plus because we figured we were gonna be somewhere around 34 to 36 yards. We ordered a whole 4 truck because we ate up a lot of concrete somewhere. I ain't sure where yet, but we ate a lot up. So we ordered a whole another truck, 10 more yards. And yeah, you got to wait on the plant. So we feel like that's going to take care of us. It's going to be close, but we should be good. So that's what we're waiting on. We've got the big footing. I mean, we got the mechanical room footing up top done. Both footings on that side done. Halfway done with this one. And the roof of the pump house cut. You got the floor of the pump house, the hallway. Fix my little goof up there that we talked about before, and half of this one. So we're looking to do that with 10 yards. So if it takes more than that, it's Santiago's fault.
Look,
if it takes more than 10 yards, to finish.
It takes more than 10 yards. It sounds like a person.
So this is truck number 4. We're gonna pump the floor of the pump room and go ahead and get that done. And then whatever's left, we're gonna fill this hole in. That's been a little thing we need to take care of the whole time. I've talked about it in an earlier video.
and then whatever's left, they'll pump out in there. And then when the other truck gets here, they're just going to finish it with tailgate there and up top, so the pump can go ahead and get out of here. It was overkill to have the pump, but CMP takes care of me, so made it a little easier on us. And there you go. All right, let's go. We're just pumping some concrete down into this void that we ended up with on the wall pour, and we're vibrating as we go to get it really down in there and fill that up and consolidate it really well. It was about a quarter yard or so. So it was a decent amount. I've talked about this before, but we got it taken care of.
All right, it's the last pour. We're gonna just tailgate it. This is the first tailgate pour out here, I think. Everything else has been pumped. So we're gonna put that in there and I'm gonna vibrate it, and we're gonna make something happen. There we go. Do something
that. So we tailgated this one, and I'm going along and vibrating not a lot, but you'll see that I'm getting in there with the vibrator and just letting it get down around the rebar, because this one's so tight for us. I mean, there's lots of pours that are tighter than this, but we did 8-inch on centers, number 5 bar, so I got it to get down in there next to the form really well, and the wall just everywhere, so that it would be really consolidated. This is the area over the underground tunnel, so this will end up being covered up and you'll never see it again, but so we want it to be really strong because you'll drive over this. And so this has been something I wanted to tick off the list so I didn't have to worry about it anymore.
All right, that's it, that's a wrap. This, will be left semi rough. They'll smooth it out like he's doing. That's about it. And then this all, we'll pull the rock back, take the forms off. This all gets waterproofed and then covered up.
Hope you enjoyed it. It was a little quick pour overall compared to what we've been doing, but interesting nonetheless, and appreciate everybody.
All right, it's the end of the day. Everybody left a long time ago, but footings are ready. Start stacking the walls, and there's done. Up here's done. This gets travertine over top of it at some point. That gets all the pool equipment, so I can set that whenever now. He's gonna start Monday on the walls. Now I'm gonna sit back the rest of the weekend, and I've got taxes to do, which sucks, but how it is. So gotta do some stuff with that and finish up my game plan for what I want to work on next, if it's going to be focusing on the pool or if we're going to stack the next floor of the house or whatever we want to do. So that's got to get figured out, and that's it. So long day, well worth it. Feels good just get a little bit more out of the way with this stuff, and on to the next.
I am fairly well now, I am strong, I am goodbye, I'm a long way from home. I am an orchard at the start of spring. I am a mockingbird, I love to sing. And I'm gonna fly, I'm gonna fly. I am an old road, walking on my feet. I am laughing neath the weeping willow tree. I am a dog barking, a honeybee sting. I ain't no angel, but I've got my wings. I'm gonna fly, I'm gonna fly.